Hello guys, welcome to another tutorial. Now that we are on the Halloween season, I am going to explain to you how you can create a pumpkin using Blender 2.9. Just one thing before we start this tutorial, you can always look at the bottom left of the screen to see which keys or mouse buttons am I clicking or typing during this tutorial. I hope that it can be helpful to you. I think it is. So let's start this tutorial. The first thing that we need to do is to remove all the objects from the scene. Just drag and drop, select them all, and then press the delete or the X key to remove. The next thing that we are going to do is to add a sphere. We are going to use a sphere because it's the object that is more similar to a pumpkin. So press Shift A, Mesh, and add the sphere. Before you do anything else, just click here on the bottom left of the screen and change the segments to 24 and the rings to 26. I am going to create now the edges of the pumpkin, but to do that I am going to remove some faces and use the mirror modifier, because I don't want to repeat all the process on the circumference, on the sphere. So let's do that by clicking on 7 to go to the top view. Okay. Make sure that you have X-ray activated so that you can see all the vertices on your object, and press Tab to go to edit mode, and then drag and drop the top of the sphere so that you can have all those vertices selected over here. Let's remove them by pressing the delete or the X key, and over here select vertices. Let's do the same for this side. You should have now a quarter of a sphere. We are ready to add the modifier, and to do that, just click here on the modifiers tab, select add and mirror. Okay. Probably by default you have only the X axis activated. Let's select the Y axis also. Next, we need to squeeze the sphere on the top and on the bottom so that we can have a sphere that is more like a pumpkin. I am doing this by selecting the top and the bottom vertices and scale them on the Z axis. But if I do this using the traditional method by clicking on S and Z, as you can see, I am always moving the vertices that I have selected. That's not what I want. I want to move these two, but I want to move all those that are near them. So to do that, we need to activate proportional editing over here. Just click here. Make sure that you have the smooth property activated, and then you just need to press S and Z to lock on the Z axis. You have probably noticed that now we can see a little circle around our object. This circle allows you to change the number of vertices that are near the vertices that you have selected that you want to move. I will gonna show you. For example, if I scale a little bit down, as you can see, it have moved not only the vertices that we have selected, but a few ones that are near them. And if you rotate your mouse wheel up or down, you can decrease or increase the number of vertices that are going to move. You can make this according to your personal taste. For me, I am going to do something like This I think that is good. And the next thing that I am going to do is to remove these faces over here and these faces over here. To do that, make sure that you have the face selected. Okay. Just select them. And press the delete or the X key. And then select faces. Now let's do the edges of the pumpkin. Make sure that you have clipping selected. For that, we need to create four edge loops. One over here, next to this one. I am choosing this one because it is in the center. Okay, we have three to this side and three to this side. And I am going to create another one over here and another one over here. So, Control R to create an edge loop. And let's move it here. Control R to create another one. And let's move it here. More or less, you don't have to be precise with this. Control R to create another one here. And Control R to create another one on this side. Now I need to select this one over here. You can press Shift Alt. I'm going to select the middle one, Shift with Shift and Alt pressed. Okay. And this one over here. After you have all of them selected, press S. I'm sorry. Let's deactivate over here the proportional editing. And now let's press S and move it down a little bit. I think that's good. Let me just deactivate the X-ray mode so that we can see how it looks. It looks good. Now first, after you see that the shape is good for you, we need to apply the mirror modifier so that we can work with all the sphere and not only this part. To do that, make sure that you are not on edit mode. Click here and then apply. Now, if you click on tab to go to edit mode, as you can see, we have access to all the mesh. The next thing is to close this gap over here on the bottom. So make sure that you have the edge over here selected. Let's click on one edge and then Shift and Alt to select all the edge loop. Okay. As you probably notice, you have here some edges that are not on the same position on the Z-axis as this one. So we are going to correct that. Press S to scale, then Z to lock it on the Z-axis, and then 0. Okay, now they are on the same position on the Z-axis, and then press F to close the gap. We have created an N-gon here. If you don't know what is an N-gon is a face that have more than 4 vertices. Okay, we shouldn't use it, but for this case I think that we will not have any problem. So after doing that, it's time to design the eyes and the mouth. So press 1 to go to the front view. Okay. To do that, we are going to use the knife tool. Make sure that you are on edit mode and select the knife tool over here. You can do this using your imagination, or you can do it just like me. That's up to you. Let's design the eyes. When you are done, when you close the circle, make sure that you press enter. Let's do the same for this side. Over here. No. Let's do it again. This one. This one. This one. And press enter when you're done. Okay. Now make sure that you have over here the face select. Click here on the select box and then press shift to select those edges, shift to select these ones. Press delete and select faces. Okay, now we have our eyes. Let's do the same for the mouth. Click again on the knife tool. For the mouth, let's do something like this. I'm sorry, I'm going to start. Press the S key to start. That's up to you what is the shape that you are going to use for the mouth. I think that's good. This one, so I'm going to remove those edges over here. Okay, you should have something like this or similar according to what you want your pumpkin to look like, and then press the delete and the X key, or the X key to delete the faces. Okay, now we have some mouth over here. That's good. I thought that I have closed this gap before, but I don't know what I have done. Probably Ctrl Z or something. I'm sorry. Now it's done. As you probably know, the pumpkins have some thickness, so we need to add them. We can do this by add a modifier that is called solidify. Okay, and then let's increase the number of the thickness over here. I think that is good. And now the next thing that we want to do is to apply when you think it is good, and then let's add another modifier that is called a subdivision surface. Okay, Now that we have had our subdivision, as you can see, it have created our smoothed our pumpkin. Let's add a shade smooth so that our surface can be smoother. That start to looking good, and then press tab to go to the edit mode, and let's tune some edges over here. The first thing that you probably notice is this part is too rounded. Okay, we are going to correct it. So press tab, control R to add some edge loops, and let's create one over here. Another one on the back, control R. That's good. Let's do the same for the eyes, control plus R. And again. On the other one. That's pretty good. I like the result. If you can, of course, this is up to you. You can tweak more or less. Let me just select a few vertices over here and scale it, because on the pumpkins, these holes over here are not completely with the same sizes. So I'm trying to give some more realistic look over here. You can do this randomly. I'm sorry, according to your taste. Just need a little bit patience, but these details are the ones that will going to give the realism to your scene. It will be more or less realistic, depending on the time that you spend with the details. This is just for this tutorial. I am not going to spend too much time with this. That's good. Now let's do the top of the pumpkin. So make sure that you have left the edit mode by pressing tab. And then click 1 to go to the front view, Shift A, add mesh, and then a cylinder. We are not going to use 32 vertices, maybe 12. 12 is too much, maybe 6, 8. Okay, 8 is good. Now press S to scale it down. G to move, and Z to move it along the Z axis. That's good. Now press Tab to enter in edit mode and make sure that you have the X-ray activated. Control R, I'm sorry, Control R to add some edge loops. Then select the bottom vertices and scale them. That's good. I'm just moving this up a little bit, so press G and Z to move them up. That's good. Let's scale them a little bit, and then E and Z and scale it again. Nice. And then E and Z to extrude them on Z. Let's rotate those vertices, press select them and press R to rotate. Let's scale these ones over here and then move them, scale them. You can always do this scale and rotate and according to your personal taste. Okay, if you are not seeing what am I doing, I am just selecting the vertices, scaling them or rotating them to make the head of the pumpkin. I am doing a little bit quicker, but I am doing this because the final result is up to you, so you can tweak them what you need. That's good. Now we have the top. The next thing that we need to do is to add again a subdivision modifier. Select 3 and smooth the object. As you can see, this is not very realistic. We need to add some edges over here, and to do that, click on Tab to go to edit mode and then create some edge loops. Control R. I'm going to create one over here. Control plus R, another one over here. Over here, another one. That's up to you. You don't need to be too much perfect to have too much perfection with this. You should check how it looks. Okay, that's good. For me, it is perfect. Now let's add some lights to the scene. First, move all the objects to the top in order so that they will be on the zero on the Z axis. So select all of them, press G and Z, and move them to this near to this red line over here, and then shift A and let's add a plane. Press S to scale the plane and then maybe 100. I want the plane to look bigger. The next thing, go here to the render properties. We are going to use cycles, but this will work with Eevee also. Let's add some textures to the scene and go to the shading tab, select the pumpkin and create new. Let's select the orange color on the diffuse. A little bit darker or lighter, that's up to you. For the top, let's do the same, but let's use the green color. I'm sorry. Again, that's up to you. For me, this is very good. Now it's time to add some lights. If you click here on viewport shading, As you can see, our final render will look like this, but we don't have any lights on the scene. So Shift A and then light. And for this case, we are going to use an area. Press S and then G and Z. Let's go here to the light parameters and let's increase this to maybe the power to 100. That's good. Now let's go here to the world properties. We want it to be in the night, so let's change the color to the black over here. Okay, you probably notice a little line, a little gray line. That's because the plane doesn't have the enough size. So select the plane, press S and then 2 maybe. No, S10. That's good. And now let's create a light in the center of the pumpkin so that it can give us that effect of a candle inside of it. So Shift A, light. We are going to use a point for this, G and Z to move it on the Z axis. As you can see, that light is inside of our pumpkin. Let's see how it looks. It is looking good. I don't want too much light on the exterior, so I will select this one over here and maybe change it to 60. Let's see how it looks. I think that looks better. And for this one over here on the inside, we are going to use maybe 100. Yes, even more. I think that we can use more. So 150. Yes, that's it. I think this is too much yet, maybe 30. I think that looks very good. This is the final result of our work. I hope that you have liked it. If you have liked it, please subscribe my channel. And thanks a lot for watching.